In this session, first we'll learn about Object Snap toolbar. And to get the Object Snap toolbar, you can right click anywhere on the existing toolbars, and from the list you can choose here Object Snap toolbar. So select it. Now this is called Object Snap toolbar, and in this we'll see few snapping options related with lines. Now the first one will go with snap to endpoint. Here we got snap to endpoint. I will tell you what is this snap to endpoint. First let me create here one horizontal line. Pick the first point, let me switch on the ortho, and I am creating here one horizontal line. Then go with escape. Now after this, if I want to draw a line from the endpoint of this first one, exactly if I want to snap this endpoint, then I can do it by going with snap to endpoint. Snapping is nothing but exactly picking that particular point. If I want to pick exactly the endpoint, then I can pick it using snap to endpoint. So if I want to use this icon, first I have to go to line, select the line command, because I want to draw a line. So I am going to line, and by default if you see, it is not going to highlight exactly the endpoints, it won't highlight. But if you want to pick the endpoint of this existing line, just you can go snap to endpoint, select the icon, and now if you move to the endpoint, it is going to highlight the endpoints with squares like this. Now you can click here and you can create the next one. So this is about snap to endpoint. And one more, if I want to draw here from the start point of the first line, then again I can go with line, say snap to endpoint, go to the endpoint and snap it. So this is about snap to endpoint. We will see one more example. Let me go with a rectangle. Roughly I am creating here one rectangle. Now if I want to draw a line from this endpoint to this endpoint, I can go with line. Let me switch off the ortho. Now I want this endpoint, so I am going snap to endpoint, pick this endpoint. Then I want this endpoint. So to use this endpoint, once again we have to go with snap to endpoint. That means after selecting the icon, you can use it only once. Once again, if you want to snap the other point, you have to choose the icon one more time. Or select the snap to endpoint again and go to the required endpoint and snap it. Similarly, one more line diagonally if I want to draw, again I can go to line, say snap to endpoint, pick this one, and again the other endpoint you can pick by going to snap to endpoint and pick it. So this is about snapping the endpoints of the line. Then next we'll see about the second icon, that is snap to midpoint. Now here if I want to draw a line from the midpoint of the top line to the midpoint of the bottom line, I can go to line. And if I want to snap exactly the midpoint, I can go snap to midpoint, select the icon and go to the line. It will highlight the midpoint with a triangle, equilateral triangle. Select the midpoint. Then if I want to end the second one here at the bottom midpoint, then again I should go snap to midpoint and let me pick here. Similarly, one more, I want to draw horizontally between these two vertical midpoints. So go to line, snap to midpoint, pick the first one, again go snap to midpoint and pick the second one. Now this is about picking the midpoints. Then next we'll see about snap to intersection. Snap to intersection means you can pick the intersection points. For example, let me draw here two lines which are intersecting with each other. Similarly, on the right side also I am creating here two lines. Now if I want to create a line between these two intersections, I can go to line, I can say snap to intersection, pick the first intersection point, and for intersection you will be having a cross mark. For endpoints we have seen a square, for midpoint we have seen a triangle. Now for this intersection you will be having a cross mark. Now pick that intersection point, then again you can go with snap to intersection and select the second intersection point. So these are the three important snapping options related with the line: snap to endpoint, snap to midpoint and snap to intersection. Then about the remaining options we'll see in the later sessions. Now let me keep this toolbar aside, let me dock it. Then we'll try to delete all these existing lines. Then now we'll start the next method of creating the objects, which is called absolute coordinates method. And in this absolute coordinate method, we are going to use the coordinate values of each and every point through which the lines are passing through. If I want to create a rectangle, now I am not going to pick the corners of the rectangle on the screen, but instead of picking the corners, I am going to give the input through the command prompt, and the input will be in terms of the coordinates. Now according to the coordinates which we are giving as input, the figure will be created. And we call it as absolute coordinates method because whatever the coordinates we are going to specify here, they will be calculated with respect to the default origin of the screen. Now this is nothing but the default origin. Now from this default origin, it is going to calculate the coordinate values which we are specifying. So now we'll see an example here. Let us go with the similar figure which we have created using the grid. Now same rectangle we'll try to create here with the help of the absolute coordinates method. Now I want to create only this rectangle, so let us set the limits for this rectangle. And if you see this rectangle in this, the maximum dimension is nothing but 13. And I told you already in the last sessions, whenever you want to set the limits for any figure, we have to concentrate on the maximum dimension, and you can take the limits as slightly greater than the maximum dimension value. So because here the maximum dimension is 13, let us go with AutoCAD, and here let me take the limits slightly greater than the 13. So I am going to limits, lower left I am taking as usual 0, 0, and the upper right corner let me take 15, 15. I am taking both x and y values as 15 and 15. This 15 is slightly greater than the 13, that is the maximum dimension of the rectangle. So specify here the upper right as 15, 15, then go with enter. Now immediately let us go with z enter, a enter. Now this is the origin. Now here I am going to create this particular figure by specifying the coordinate values of these four corners of the rectangle. Now let us think that I am going to start from 0, 0. If I am taking this left side corner as 0, 0, then you can specify the remaining coordinate values with respect to that start point. Let us start exactly from 0, 0. So I am going back to AutoCAD. Let me go to line, L enter. And when it is asking here to specify the first point, let me give the input as 0, 0, x, y I am giving as 0, 0 because I want to start from the origin. So specify 0, 0 and go with enter. And after going with enter, you can see here the line is starting exactly from the origin. Then to create this horizontal line, I have to specify now this right side point coordinate values. Already I have given the left side as 0, 0. Then right side values, if you see this figure, you can specify the right side coordinate values as 13, 0, because horizontal, that is x, is 13 and there is no y, so you can take this as 13, 0. Now let me specify here, when it is asking specify the next point, I am giving the input as 13, 0 from the keyboard, then go with enter. Now we got the line of 13 units. Then now we have to specify here the third point coordinates, and again the third point coordinates we have to calculate from the same start point. So if I calculate from the start point the third point coordinates, then that will be 13, 8. So horizontal it is 13 and vertical it is 8. So the coordinates of the third point will be 13, 8. Let me go back to the AutoCAD. Here I am giving the third point coordinates as 13, 8. You can see here in the command prompt, then go with enter. Then to specify the coordinate values of this fourth one, again you can count it from the same origin. If I count it from the origin, then the point coordinates will be 0, 8, because always, as I told, we have to calculate with respect to the origin. So from the origin, if I move to this point, the coordinate will be 0, 8. So So let me go with AutoCAD, and here I am giving as 0, 8. Then I want to close this figure by reaching the same point. So because I have started from 0, 0, once again let me specify the endpoint also as 0, 0. Then now we can go with escape. So here we have created a rectangle of 13 by 8 using the absolute coordinates method. Then few more examples related with this absolute coordinates method we'll see in the next session.